Hi, I'm Dr. Tracey Marks, a psychiatrist, and I make mental health education videos. One of my community members asked me if they could microdose their prescription medication to help them tolerate the side effects of the medication. So first of all, what is microdosing? Microdosing usually refers to how to take a psychedelic substance like LSD or psilocybin. The way it works is you take a tiny dose, around a 10th or a 20th of a recreational dose. The idea is to get the cognitive and emotional benefits from the drug without experiencing the dissociative effects. The dissociative effects would be things like feeling separated from your body, seeing your environment move, or not being able to judge distance properly. Some people will even experience intense fear or hallucinate. People who advocate for microdosing report benefits like enhanced creativity, improved mood, increased energy, and heightened focus. But the scientific research is still trying to catch up with these claims. Some studies using brain imaging shows changes in brain activity similar to those who take the larger doses of the psychedelics, while other studies, like one that I have referenced in the description, show that using tiny amounts of specific mushrooms did change how people felt, but made some mental functions worse. So the jury is still out on how beneficial and safe it is to microdose psychedelics. Also, let's not forget that in most states, psychedelics like mushrooms and LSD are illegal.
You're under arrest.
So you're on your own with getting a reliable source of it. So that's psychedelics. Prescription medications are a completely different ballpark. Unlike recreational drugs, prescription medications are designed with very specific pharmacokinetics. Pharmacokinetics are how the drug is absorbed, distributed in your body, metabolized, and then excreted. Also, a fundamental principle in pharmacology is the concept of the minimum effective dose. This is the smallest dose of a drug that produces a therapeutic response. Doses less than that aren't likely to do much for your symptoms and only subject you to side effects. But let's look at some real examples. Prozac is an antidepressant. The smallest dose that it comes in is 10 milligrams. The usual effective dose for depression is between 20 and 60 milligrams, with a maximum dose of 80 milligrams. How much ends up working for you depends on how you metabolize the drug. Most of the psychiatric medications are metabolized in the liver, and those liver enzymes are controlled by your genes. If you are a slow metabolizer, you don't break down the medication as fast, and you can accumulate more of the drug in your system. You can get genetic testing to determine your metabolic status, but the testing is expensive, and if you don't have access to it, a clue that you could be a slow metabolizer is if you are someone who seems to have a lot of side effects from what would be considered a normal dose of the medication, and you always seem to need smaller doses. Rapid metabolizers break down the drug quickly and usually need higher doses of the medication to get it to work. If this describes you, you may have a history of taking medications and having them not seem to work unless you took really high doses. The normal metabolizers break down the drugs at a rate that is expected, and for you, the normal dose range is what should work for you. But let's say you are someone who is a slow metabolizer and 20 milligrams of Prozac gives you a lot of side effects like nausea, diarrhea, and maybe even trouble sleeping. You may be able to see some benefit by taking 10 milligrams or 5 milligrams of Prozac. But if you try to apply the microdosing standard to Prozac, and we believe that 20 milligrams is the minimum therapeutic amount for a normal metabolizer, a microdose would be 1 or 2 milligrams. Now, first of all, it would be very difficult to get 1 milligram out of a 10 milligram tablet. Many of the smaller pills turn to dust when you start trying to cut them multiple times. But even so, you'd have to do some pretty precise measurements to collect all of the dust and still try and get 1 milligram out of that. Given that the minimum therapeutic dose is 20 milligrams, it's doubtful that 1 milligram of Prozac is going to be very effective, but you could still experience some side effects from that small dose. Some medications will come as a liquid to allow you to be able to take small doses, but those medications are in the minority, and it's much more likely that whatever you're prescribed is not going to be available as a liquid. But if you're someone who is a slow metabolizer and seems to respond to really tiny doses of medications, you would need to preferentially look for medications that come in liquid form and then use syringes to take drops of the medication. Another thing to consider if you go down the road of taking smaller doses of your medication to manage side effects is you cannot cut or crush drugs that are an extended release formulation. The extended release mechanism is typically part of the coating on the outside of the tablet. Once you cut that coating, you lose the extended release feature. And then a medication that was designed to last for 24 hours may only last in your system for a few hours. Some extended release medications will come in a capsule form, but you're still not supposed to open the capsule unless it's specifically designed for that. Like Vyvanse has spansoles inside the capsule, and these little beads still maintain their extended release pharmacokinetics if you take them out of the capsule. So you are able to open that capsule and take a portion of the inside contents. Not all extended release drugs have an XR or ER in the name. They will usually have some kind of coating though on the outside or come in a capsule. If you're not sure, you can always ask your pharmacist if it's a medication that you can cut or crush. Now, there are reasons that some people may want to take a smaller dose of a medication than what is recommended, like if you need a very slow titration schedule. Titration is the process of starting low and then moving up the dose up to higher doses to get a better effect. If you need that process to be slower than usual, you may need to request that your doctor put you on medications that have liquid form, or if there's not a liquid form, make sure that it's a medication that breaks easily into smaller pieces without disintegrating. But know that if you have a slow titration, it may take longer to get the desired results from the medication. We expect that antidepressants will take 4 to 6 weeks to work when prescribed at a therapeutic dose. So if your doctor prescribes you 50 milligrams of Zoloft and you decide that you want to be cautious and take a fourth or an eighth of that tablet and see how it goes, it may take you 2 to 3 months to get the improvement you want. I hope this was helpful. Thanks for watching. See you next time.